Scubascope is sponsored by
Metropolitan International University.
Poor child, wake up in the morning to see a lot of, you know, there was a lot going on social media. I'm like, what is happening? Whose nudes have leaked? Only to find out Vince Musisi is up in arms and he is trying so hard to get Uber and put them in a particular place. But immediately when people saw what Vince was trying to talk about, we're all concerned. Now the Uber drivers dive in, the female ones, the male ones, and then other passengers drive in, and they're all trying to give their point of view. Everyone is screaming and shouting and yelling, and I couldn't hear it. I needed it to quieten down so that I can understand what exactly went wrong. I need to understand the entire story, and I think I have. I honestly think I have. Vince could be right, Uber could be right, and then there's that chick in the middle there who is just not supposed to be in the mix because she just looks like, she was the thief here. Anywho, that is of course going to be on today's episode of Scoop and Scoop. Not forgetting, we have a lot more happening in Celebrityville. We have Apus calling someone a monkey. Did he? And then we have Joe Steady also calling Apus something else. And then we still have Bebe Cool. No, I'm not talking about Bebe Cool today. I cannot. Oh yeah! And then there's that useless comeback. Yesterday I talked about how Wyke Bender could be breaking up or had broken up with his chick. Well, they come out and they're like, no, we have not broken up. Now, I'll give you the deets and why I'm actually very pissed off that they think we're that stupid. Or he is that stupid. I don't know. Auntie Nefarious One, welcome. You know, I'm not one to really bite into what is the latest thing happening. Okay, yes, I am one. Why am I lying? So anyway, this whole Vince Musisi thing, a lot has been talked about. The post itself has over 100 comments. It has like about 12 shares at the moment as we speak. No, they're actually 300 comments now. I'm counting. So this is what, according to Vince Musisi, he says that Uber drivers have learned a way of doing, well, at first I thought it was a hack, but then I understood it. He says he was charged exorbitantly for a fee. No, a fare. I'm not even making sense because this thing is just confusing. He ordered an Uber for someone. You know, you can order for someone. He gets there, the fare was supposed to be 31K. That is what they told him. And then when the Uber reaches him, they're saying 90K. Now he says, what these guys do, they take you like, I can take you from here at New Vision and take you to Ntinda. And let's say your fare is 90,000. Let's just give or take. Instead of him really ending the trip and that is your real fare, he will end that particular trip, take a screenshot of just the fare and that green background, wait for Nacha Yune coming from somewhere else when she sits in the car to go make a second trip after the first one. When she asks for her fare, instead of using the real app fare, he will use the screenshot that he took. Now yes, I have had people complain about that, and it's really unfortunate. You know, story is Vince Musisi was leaving Kabalagala to go to Chiwatule. He took an Uber. Now, according to the Uber, he was supposed to pay 31K. According to Belinda, his Uber driver, well, when they got to Chiwatule, it was 90K. Vince is like, hold up! How did it get to 90K from Kabalagala to Chiwatule? And then he texts to social media and he's like, I can't believe this, Uber, you need to sort this out. There are thugs in your whole system. What they do is that they take a screenshot of a higher amount, and when they're driving another client, they'll just use a screenshot as the final amount. And if you're not vigilant enough, yes, you are going to end up paying a higher amount. But he says, yeah, yabademulabi. He did not. But I'm like, well, you know what? Let's face it. I don't know what is wrong with us Ugandans. At this point, I cannot begin bashing Uber. I cannot begin bashing, Vince Musisi. But let me start with bashing Uber drivers. This is just it. Because I use Uber a lot. I do love to use it, you know? It is very convenient. It is fast. It doesn't matter if the driver is bad-mannered. If you can get me to my destination in peace and just not talk, hallelujah. But I don't know what is wrong with you drivers. Mutu de waka temulina midimo baba lete de a situation that can give you money at the comfort of you using your own car to just drive around Kampala, and you still want to Well, you still want to take that little from it too. As in, I don't get it. This is not the first time I've had this complaint. I've had it so many times. It has never happened to me because the day it will happen, it will not just be a conversation on social media. Me and my Uber driver will definitely head to the nearest police station. That is how vigilant I am. And then another thing, you Uber driver, you Uber users, before we can even shout at the drivers, you know you have an app for a reason, for crying out loud. When you order for an Uber, it gives you a rough estimate, for crying. It says from here to here, well, you can pay about 6,000. Now, if you have way too many stops, or you had to go get fuel, or there was traffic, or what, the meter will keep running. You have to put all of that into consideration, but you already have an estimate. So there's no way I am going to know that I'm supposed to pay, let me see, around 50,000, and then you get me to my destination, and you're telling me I'm paying 200K. Are you crazy? It is sad that that happened to you, and I'm so glad that you brought it to our attention. We are very, very happy as Ugandans that, well, that's another one for the books. But what's this whole situation I see? When you put up the post, there were like about 4 or 5 drivers who are hollering. They're like, Vince Tukumanyi, so Abi, now you order Ubers for your nyam nyams that you're going to eat in your in your passenger, what, right? So, and you never, never pay. Walinga, bamitani, dube, dube, atasa sura boda. That Twitter drama that was so beautiful and is still going on, it came to our artists. Now, you know, January is definitely a month where nothing is happening. I call it Jan-wari. But Bebe Cool and Eddie Kenzo came through with it, you know? They had their petty beef. It's still going on. Ready and Wizard jumped in. Different artists also wanted to jump in and all of that. For me, it was a blast because the worst time to be a person in the gossip columns is now. There is nothing happening. There is no concerts. People don't want to party that much because they don't have enough money to party. There is no music going to be put out there because everyone is still in the holiday days. So they pick up like at around, let's say, March-ish there. That's when it picks up. But to see that you people have managed to pick it up in January, I am excited. So yesterday, I see Apis and Joe Steady going at it. I'm like, first of all, how old are these idiots? Joe Steady just looks like a 12-year-old. No, he looks like a 50-year-old trapped in a 12-year body. You know? That's just the look, first of all. Apis, Bagonza, Chupadebe. I don't even know how to start with him. Because we all don't know what he's doing. He's just a very, very tall, confused child on the inside. In Apis' mind and how he acts, he has tendencies of a 5-year-old. I'm just being honest. So y'all start this whole back and forth. Justed is telling Apis that he is tired of looking after Apis's crowd while he has no music out. It's about time. I'm like, okay. And Apis is there like, yo, you better recognize. I'm the truth. I'm the deal. I am this. I'm like, first of all, Apis, I know you are trying to put your music out there. I do know that for a fact. You have an entire album and a lot is riding on it. And right about now, you're finna get into any situation that you feel is going to put you out there. I get it. If it means being petty, if it means being stupid, if it means you doing all the ridiculousness that you do on the gram, you're going to do that because this has to work for you. Because I know nothing has worked in, well, sometime. Now for you, Joe Steady. What makes you honestly think that you've been entertaining Apis's listeners? Last time I checked, Joe Steady does Token Deza and Apis was doing Teacher. Be thinking a bit here. Okay. I'm not just going to sit on the fence on this one. Let's come correct because it's supposed to be a battle. So let me put where my thoughts fall. First of all, I'm going to start with Joe Steady. What can we tell Joe Steady? What is there to tell Joe Steady? As in, calm down. We get it. It's your time, you know? It's your time. Do you? There was a time when you came out and no one really respected what you had done because we all felt you were knock off after you did that Eli Wamala song. It's a legendary song. Anybody who does it is going to be respected. So calm down. It is about your time. We're understanding, yes, like a musical scene, good for you. Shut up. Don't make yourself too important, because as far as we are concerned, you might left with like about 1, 2, 3 songs left in your lifetime, and the rest are just going to be cheap knockoffs of different things. So, sala presa, and you calm down. As for Apus, this is what I'm going to say. I honestly feel that Apus exhibits tendencies. Now, this is not me being insensitive. This is just me giving my opinion. Apus exhibits tendencies of someone suffering from ADHD. Like, think about it. Like, Apus lives for the attention. He craves for it. He needs it. There's wanting something, and then there's needing it. Apus is on the need side of everything. Imagine if he posted and he only got one comment and one like. That would be the day when hell hath no fury, like Apus not liked and commented on. So I think because of that, the ADHD situation, I talked about how Wyke Bender took to social media and penned down something so heartfelt. It was like one of those, goodbye is the saddest thing I'll ever. Is that the, are those the words that said in the old song? Someone like you. It was like we're listening to an Adele song or Celine Dion, one of those Cry Me a River type of songs. It was a long message. And the very first thing that popped up in our minds, and honestly for anybody who went to school, got an education, and really likes to read in between the lines, it really sounded like a goodbye to this relationship. So we were like, yo, did they just break up? Man, that was a long, touchy, heartfelt, felt from the core type of message. And then, as we're still trying to understand what could have happened, was it groupies? Was it the groupies? Did she move on? Did she find someone richer? Did she just wake up and it wasn't working? What went wrong? These idiots, apparently a source close to Wyke Bender and his fiance, yes, she is a fiance, come out and they're like, no, you people, what is wrong with you? No, Bender was just writing a message telling his chick bye because she was going somewhere far away to work for some time. So he was just putting his heart out there that it's going to be a long time, but you love me and all of that things. Then they're not broken up. I was like, the what? The what? Which school did this boy go to? What's on Medawa? Anyway, apparently they're still together. He was just telling his wife, Ngabo Bango, Vekoti Dongo, Genda Kampala. No more wishing a SF Gen. And that's pretty much all I had for today in this very, very confusing times of January when pretty much nothing is happening. But you know you can trust your sister to always get you something. I always have to get you something because there's always something happening, though it's not the juicy kind of stuff, but there's always something happening. @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle on, of course, Twitter. And on Instagram, it's @TinaFierce1 with an H on the Tina. Not forgetting on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and TinaFierce1. Like the page, follow, and anytime you want to say something, holler at me, ask about anything. Those are the handles that you can reach me at. And I'm always ready and willing to give you the latest deets in Celebrityville or Celebrityville. Yep. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop and Scoop was sponsored by
Metropolitan International University.